In this video, we're going to be showing you how to assemble the Eyes of the Nine. We'll be building each member of the warband in order they feature in the instruction guide. Now, there's a few things you need to get together before you start building. First of all, you need a set of clippers like these. You'll also need a mold line remover, looks like that. I'll also recommend just having a read of the instructions as well, just to familiarise yourself with which parts go where. And also, you'll notice that every part is numbered. This just makes it a lot easier to track down the bits that you need when you're clipping them out. Now, the first model we're going to build is Narvia. Now, she's at parts 1, 2, 3 and 4. We're going to start with parts 1 and 2, which are featured just here. So that's part 1 and that's part 2. So what we're going to do is when we start clipping them out, I'm just going to get the flat side of my clippers as close as I can to the model and then just gently snip away, like so. I'm just going to keep twisting around just to make it easy to clip around. And also, before I clip that last bit out, I'm just going to make sure I've got it supported just in case she drops out. With those parts clipped out, what we're going to do now is remove any mould lines. Now, a mould line usually runs through the middle of a figure. You'll be able to see by a little line there. Now, that's the two parts of the mould line that come apart and go together. So what we're going to do is get a mould line removed and just gently just scrape that line away. Also, where you've clipped the model, you might get a little nubbing, so you just need to put a little bit of force on there. That'll also get rid of that. But don't worry, it might look a bit discoloured, but once you start painting, that'll disappear and you won't see it. You want to do this on both the parts you've clipped out. There we are, with those two parts now clipped out and cleaned, what I'm going to do is we're going to assemble them. Now the first thing I'll do before any assembling is I'm just going to just do a little test fit just to make sure I can get the orientation right. And then once I'm happy, what I'll then do is just push those parts together like so. There we are, clipped together, a nice and firm connection. What we're going to do now is we're going to cut out part 3, which is our arm holding the shield. So again, just get the flat of your clippers, like so. And just hold it before you clip the last bit out. Then what we're going to do is we're going to clean that up and then we'll show you assembling her. With the shield now cleaned up, what we're going to do is we're going to assemble it to the rest of Narvia. So what I'm going to do is again quickly just dry fit it just to make sure I'm happy with where it locates. And all I'm going to do is just push that on like so. And there we are. What we're going to do now is clip out Narvia's base, which is part 4, which is this one here. Again, flatter the clippers just to the rim of the base like so. Clip that off, and then we'll just clean around those edges just to get rid of these little marks or nubbins from the sprue. The final thing to do now with Narvi is to attach it to her base. Now she's got a little plug socket here, so all we're going to do is just place that in, and she's kind of heading towards these two little flagstones here. So it will locate in anyway because it's designed to fit in a certain way. But yeah, if you have her heading towards these two flagstones, then you can't go wrong. The next member of the warband we're going to build is Tarosh. Now he's parts 5, 6, 7 and 8. So you'll find these on the same sprue that Narvia was on. So there's 6, there's 5, there's 7 and there's 8. So what we're going to do is we're going to clip all those parts out. We'll also clean them up with the mould line remover as well. So again, just take your time and use the flat of the clippers against all those parts. With all those parts clipped out and cleaned, we're now going to get part 5 and 6. We're just going to assemble those. I'm just going to quickly test fit it like I did before. And then once I'm happy, just push those parts together, give it a nice firm push, and there we are. So the next step is to attach part 7, and this goes on his back. It's also part of his right arm as well. And then to finish Tarosh off, we're just going to attach him to his base, which is part 8. So all we need to do is just give that nice firm push into the base, like so. And there we are. With Tarosh now built, we're going to move on to Vortimus the All-Seeing. Now for this, we're going to need to clip out parts 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17. So I'm just going to pull up the sprue, just going to start snipping those bits out. So he's going to be featured mainly, in fact all of them, is on this sprue here. So I'm just going to start here with part 13. With all those parts now cleaned up, we're going to get parts 13 and 14, which is the majority of Vortimus's body. And we're just going to fit them together like so. There we are. With the body of Vortimus done, we're now going to attach part 15, which is his head. So all we need to do is just make sure that it fits in nice and snugly. Give it a little push. There we go. With his head on, we're now going to attach his arm and his staff, which is part 16. So just gently locate where you want it to go and then just push that on, like so. There we are. Finally, we're going to attach Vortimus to his base, which is part 17. And we're just going to make sure he's located. You've got a little incline for his front foot that's poking out, so just make sure you get that the right way around. Give it a nice firm push, and Vortimus, the All-Seeing, is on his base and done. The next model to build in the warband is Kacharik the Zangor, and he's build number 4. So I'm just going to pull up the sprue. You can see he's located here. And he's parts 9, 10, 11, and 12. So I'm going to start with parts 9, which is the main part of his body. We'll start clipping all the bits out. And like before, we'll just clean them off with a mold line remover. Those parts clipped out and cleaned, we're now going to assemble the main part of his body. So all we need to do is make sure those little bits push in. So I'm just going to do a little test fit just to make sure I'm happy. And then I'll just push them together like so. There we are. It's that part built. We're now going to attach part 11, which is his forearms and his head and his sword. Again, you might just need to make sure you get a nice dry fit before you start pushing this in. And then once they're all aligned, I'll start with the head first, push that in, and the rest should fit in nice and smoothly. And the last part is to attach them to part 12, which is his base. Again, just make sure you line them up and then just give them some forceful pushing, like so. The next build is the Blue Horror, and he's going to be parts 18, 19, 20, and 21. So we're just going to start clipping them out. You can see they're in this top corner just here. So I'm just going to start clipping out the main parts, his body. And again, we'll just get all these cleaned up. With all those parts built and cleaned, what we're going to do now is attach parts 19 to 20, which is the main part of the torso and his tongue. So I'm just going to grab that and place it in just there. So that's the second peg down, or the second hole down, should I say. With the tongue now attached, we're going to attach parts 18, which is his head, and his front leg. And all that's left to do is attach him to his base. And the last member of the warband to build is the Brimstone Horror, and he's parts 22 and 23. And as you have guessed, he's the last two parts remaining on the sprues. So all I'm going to do is just clip those out, and then we'll clean him up, and then we'll build him. And all we need to do now with the Brimstone Horror is attach him to his base. Now you will notice there's some little indentations in the flagstones. They're really useful as a guide, so you know which way to place him. So all we need to do is just give him a little firm push, like so, and there he is. And there we are with all the members of the Eyes of the Nine now built. They're ready to delve into the Night Vault and secure victory for Tzeentch. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy building your own Eyes of the Nine warbands. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.